Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My name is Father Joseph Klosberg. I used to be the pastor at Our Lady of Perpetual Help, and I'm very happy to be with you here this morning. First of all, I want to thank you. That's one of my favorite carols, of the Father's Love Begotten. It's just beautiful in its sentiments and its understanding of the mystery of the Incarnation that we're celebrating. The other thing is the Archdiocese came up with some guidelines for us priests and people to wear masks on entrances, and I'll be wearing it except when I'm speaking. So that's a little bit of a change. But let me begin by just wishing you all a very wonderful and beautiful Christmas season. This is the time when we find out what God thinks about us and the gift of His Son to this world. So as we begin, let us first turn in hope and prayer to our God and Father through the merciful love of His beloved Son. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came down from heaven to bring us salvation and joy. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will lead us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
soul and the family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in practicing the virtues of family life and the bonds of charity. And so, in the joy of your house, delight one day in eternal rewards. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called children of God. And so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are children, God's children now. What we shall has not been yet revealed. We do not know when it is revealed. We shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Beloved, in our hearts, do not condemn us. We have confidence in God and receive whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what he pleases. And his commandments is this: we should believe in the name of the Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another as he commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him, and he in them. And the way we know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he gave us. The word of the Lord.
Why? I think if we were the ones to choose, there'd be political leaders out there. people of respect and renown, but God chose shepherds. He had angels that are very appropriate to represent this, the heavens, but on earth, he chose maybe the lowliest members of that society, because shepherd's life was very difficult. It was very, very poor, very, very humble people. And God chose them. And that always is part of my amazement and wonder at Christmas. Why? What is God telling us? He tells us the message, but he's also telling us something in the people that he chose. Today is the Feast of the Holy Family. And this is another surprise for me. And this is one sense. You know, that is because to the outsider, these people, Mary and Joseph, and their story, they look very ordinary. You know, if you look at them like that, we know later on that the people in the village saw them as just being, or in Nazareth saw them as just being like them, you know, and actually questioning Jesus because he was the son of a carpenter. But God chose them for a reason. And maybe if we think about what we would have done, we get a little bit insight into God's choosing of Mary and Joseph among all these people. I think I was thinking when I was preparing this sermon, what would we do? Well, if God said to us, you're going to choose who gets to bring up my son, or the most important person who ever lived in your family, what would we do as a human race? Well, my guess is we would do an international kind of competition and search to find the best people. We'd be sifting through their finances and their backgrounds, their education, and put it on TV like they have The Voice or America's Got Talent. That's what we'd do, because those are the things we value. But God chose these two, Mary and Joseph, to raise his son. And when you think about it, you know, the very idea of this family, just from, not from the standpoint of faith, because this family was a source of unbelievable holiness in the world. But to the people who saw them, they were ordinary. Even their story is ordinary. They were family in crisis. I don't think I've ever seen a family that's not going through a crisis at one time or another. And yet, there they are. First of all, there's the question of the pregnancy. There's the question of Joseph accepting it. There's the idea that they're being forced out of their homes to go register in the midst of this while she's pregnant. And it's just a story of a family in crisis. Not maybe, not their own people, but cruelty. What did they do that was so different is in the scriptures, and that's the faith that they had. You know, that's what scripture tells us. They had extraordinary faith. Joseph believed in what God was going to tell him to do, and he believed it, and he perceived it. You know, it was a hard thing to believe. Mary trusted in who God was. You know, she trusted, she believed in God, but more than that, she believed in the utter goodness of God. Right along with Joseph. We were told that this child would be this one again. 2 years ago, we set him up doing all these things. They just took him back and they instilled him in Jesus. Their own faith and trust in God. And they believed in his goodness. Called Mary, say they stop answering. See, it was that wisdom. Now, I've said this because, you know, in our opening prayer, it says that God gave us, you know, this family to be a model for us. This is approachable in each one of us. is capable of trusting and believing and having faith in God and the goodness of that God. And I think for parents, it's the most important thing that they can instill in their children. Something that we can't do. The church can't do that. Only a parent can do that. And so that means that it tells us that there's a possibility of holiness in this world. And it seems strange because we don't talk about families being that as a source of it. That's what the Holy Family teaches us. That every family is capable of that. And even Jesus, you know, I mean, they taught him. We see in the gospel passage, you know, Jesus being lost in the temple. Yet another crisis. Jesus beginning now to instruct them on who the God and Father that he was. Sometimes it's not easy to do things, but we do know, you know, that Jesus accepted that as what God his Father wanted for him. And says he goes back to Jerusalem and grows in Jerusalem. So there's something very beautiful about this faith feast, and I hope you take it to heart to kind of remember, no, we're not at the level of holiness of Mary, Jesus, and Joseph. But the potential is there. And just as God saw that in them, he sees us in our families the same way. Profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, to God from not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate with the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified and Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who is spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess all my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of Christ came into the world to draw us to the Father, but has come before God, the God of hosts, in prayer.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That the church may foster the unity of families and support them in times of need. As one we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let all nations respect the rights of families to live and work together. As one we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of this human family will show tolerance and goodwill to one another. As one we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who gather here today may be instruments of peace. As one we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are preparing for marriage will be supported by their family and friends. As one we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have gone before us, especially members of our families, will live forever. As one we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, both foreign and domestic, that God will guide those working for peace and speed the day when all emergency and military personnel may return to their safely to their families. We turn to you,
Lord.
For the sick, including those in the Stern Bulletin and Rachel Falls, we turn to you,
Lord.
For the intentions we hold in our hearts, and especially for Robert Beach, Elliot Reeves, Janet Novak, and Robert Mulcher, for whom this Mass is offered, we turn to you.
Lord
God, you have taught us that whatever we ask you shall receive. Help us to keep your commandments and to live the kind of life you want. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of reconciliation, humbly asking that through the intercession of the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, you may establish our families in your grace and in your peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this awe-filled mystery, through the invisible, though invisible in his own divine nature, he appeared visible in ours, and begotten before all ages, has begun to exist in time, so that raising himself up all that is cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels we praise you, and as in joyful celebration we acclaim. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Salvation. giving thanks to you, have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, William our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but I will say a word.
Thank you.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Please join us in singing our communion hymn, number 358, Wood of the Cradle, number 358.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'd like to invite anyone who is being bringing communion to the sick or the shut-ins to come forward. We're going to have everybody at this moment. Our announcements. We thank the young people for all their hard work decorating the church and changing all the burnt lights. Amy and David Thames, Connor Nelson, Paige and Angel, Nick, Mike, Enrico Renzi, Edie Borman, and Ken Harrison changed out all the lights of our hall too. And we also thank Carl Duke Dakes and his crew for the beautiful paint work they donated to the church and the hall doors and the windows. Everyone did great work, and they were a lot of help. So thank you for all of them. Our second collection this week will go to the victims of the tornadoes in the southern states. Tuesday adoration will resume on January 4th. Masses for the New Year's weekend will be Saturday, 9 a.m. and 5 p.m., Sunday, 8 p.m. and 10:30 a.m. 2022 calendars are available at the church entrances. See our bulletin website for the Christmas Mass schedule and for more other much more details. On behalf of Father Rich, Father Gonzalo, and all the pastoral staff, I wish you a very safe and merry and blessed Christmas. And I want to thank you for the privilege of celebrating with you this wonderful gift of God, this enduring gift of His Son into this world. So appreciate you, appreciate the music, especially one of my favorite carols that always gets to me. So as we gather, let us just begin to let us pray. Bring those who refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, they may share in their company forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I'm going to have a special blessing for our families. It's taken from Paul's letter to the Ephesians, but I love it because it talks about families and their name coming from God and the importance of family and the salvation that Christ offers us. Paul prays, "For this reason, I kneel before the Father, whom every family on heaven and earth is named, that may he grant you in accord with the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with the power through the Spirit in the inner self, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, rooted and grounded in love, may have the strength to comprehend with all the holy ones what is the breadth and length, the height and the depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you might be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to accomplish far more than we can ask or imagine by the power at work within us, him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's go. Oh, I want to mention something. Tonight, today on Driving Up, I heard that Desmond Tutu, the Archbishop of Johannesburg, he died today. And he was a person of great faith and of great peace, and I hope that God gives him his eternal reward in heaven. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.